American forces working under heightened security and the threat of another terror attack as the U.S. winds down the nearly 20-year war in Afghanistan. They're racing to complete the evacuation from Kabul's airport a day after a suicide bombing at its gates, a deadly reminder of the potential violence that remains. Meanwhile, Governor Ralph Northam gave an update today on the state's effort to help with the evacuation of tens of thousands of U.S. citizens and their Afghan allies. Our Cameron Thompson tells us how you can help.
Governor Ralph Northam says since evacuations began, Dulles Airport has been the only point of entry and has seen about 14,000 people come through as of Friday morning.
The people doing this work are very tired, but yet they have summoned the energy to serve people in need, and it's nothing short, in my mind, of heroic.
Northam says Philadelphia will begin to accept flights as well, but Dulles will continue to be the main airport used. He stresses that no flights are direct from Kabul, but after screening and processing in several European and Middle Eastern countries. And when they arrive in Dulles, they're checked for COVID if they don't have a negative test in the last 72 hours.
Since the mission began 11 days ago, less than 20 people have tested positive, and those individuals are being quarantined as we speak.
COVID vaccinations are also offered, but uptake has been low. U.S. citizens arriving are offered help if needed, while the refugees have additional processing and end up at Fort Lee in Prince George County.
The operation is highly efficient there. It's safe. It is very respectful of people, and it's very good.
Because Fort Lee has capacity for just over 1,700, starting this weekend, refugees will also be sent to Marine Corps Base Quantico and Fort Pickett in Blackstone.
Fort Pickett has a current capacity of 3,800 people. It can be scaled up to house 5,000 and even 10,000 if needed.
Northam says charities are helping those people get resettled around the country, with most taking between 5 to 7 days to move on, and about 10% of them are staying in Virginia.
And Northam says he understands a lot of people have been reaching out asking how they can help with these refugees, and they say the biggest thing they're asking for right now is financial donations to nonprofits and trusted partners who are helping with this resettlement, and that you can call 211 for further information and guidance. We're